Have you ever wondered what it would be like to live forever? Or a life that exceeds the expectancy of our current life duration? Seems uncertain? But what if I tell you there is a chance that something like this can happen in the near future? Cryonics is one of the ideas that is challenging the concept of our lives and hopes for the revival of dead human beings back to life in the future. We have all seen those science fiction plots where someone enters an airtight chamber, freezes their body, and returns to life in the distant future. This plot is not as far-fetched as it seems. The imagination to freeze human bodies and bring them back alive in the future has existed since the 1960s, and cryonics is that idea. It is the study and practice of storing and freezing a recently deceased person at a low temperature in hopes that it can be brought back in the future when the medical technology is advanced enough to defreeze them and bring them back alive. Cryonics is not to be confused with cryogenics. Cryogenics is the study of things at very low temperatures. In comparison, cryonics is precisely the practice of storing and freezing human bodies and organs. If you think about it, hibernation is also a sort of cryonics process. During winter, when there is less food available, several animals slow down their metabolic rate, body temperature, and heart rate to survive and come back later when the conditions are ideal for living. Some of these animals include Arctic fish, frogs, bats, and bears. The science behind cryonics is still under experimentation. There are a lot of challenges to overcome. Our brain in particular is highly complex in anatomy and function. For this reason, it is extremely difficult to preserve the brain and then revive it later. Cryopreservation is the process involving preserving of the biological material at a low temperature. It has become the established method for storing cells, tissues, organs, and even human bodies. Today, cryopreservation methods are used to preserve bodies as well as the brain alone. There are mainly two methods for cryopreservation, freezing and vitrification. However, we will focus on vitrification in this video as that is the preferred method for cryopreserving human bodies. The goal here is to protect the organs and tissues from forming ice crystals at extremely low temperatures. To carry out the cryonics process, the subject must be legally declared dead first. Then the initial cooling of the subject is carried out at below 10 degrees Celsius to cease the biochemical and metabolic processes slowly. Each step leads up to the method of vitrification, in which the subject is rapidly cooled to the temperature of minus 196 degrees Celsius using liquid nitrogen. This is done to prevent the formation of ice crystals. Usually, to freeze a corpse, a cryoprotectant, aka antifreeze solution, is used to replace the blood in the body first. This prevents the formation of ice crystals that would otherwise damage the body's organs and veins. At the end of this, the subject's body is transferred to a tank full of liquid nitrogen, where it will stay there for the foreseeable future. As of 2014, about 250 corpses have been cryonically preserved in the United States alone, and over 1,500 people have been signed up to be frozen after their death. Many companies are offering this facility. Currently, there are at least 7 cryonics companies in the world, the majority of whom exist in the United States. The service can cost anywhere between $28,000 if you decide to preserve your brain only, all the way up to $250,000 for the whole body preservation. There are seemingly many options for people today to cryopreserve, but the longevity of cryonic companies has been questioned. Many cryonic companies of the past have failed, many don't exist anymore, and their stored corpses have been disposed of. In addition to this, cryonics has faced issues of its legality and ethical status. It has been controversial and unproven for the most part. Proving the revival of cryopreserved subject is the most challenging obstacle. Currently, no established methods can extend the human lifespan, let alone resurrection after death. The revival would involve repairing the damages caused by freezing. Research has revealed that different cells, tissues, and organs require tailored processes of cryopreservation, and so far we know the current cryopreservation method is identical for the whole body. In this case, revival may not be guaranteed even with advanced technological capabilities. As for the future of cryonics, a significant amount of research is currently focused on advanced bioengineering, including nanotechnology-engineered cryoprotectants and nanobots for cellular repair. How long will it take to see a successful revival of a cryopreserved subject? Your guess is as good as mine. Many experts' optimistic estimates for revival are as little as 50 years. However, the time frame is commonly considered to be hundreds of years. A recently conducted survey of the internet users in the United States showed the estimate time that people predicted was 82 years. Would this be the moment when humanity would have achieved immortality? The ultimate expectation is the revival of cryopreserved bodies. Whether or not this goal will come to fruition in the near future remains to be seen. Will we start to look at death differently then? And do you think people should freeze themselves like this? Let me know in the comments. If you would like to see more of this, be sure to check out my previous videos and don't forget to subscribe. Hit the bell icon to stay notified of the upcoming videos. And if you have some future video suggestions, comment down below.